Hello everyone, my name is Gabrielle. This is a video tutorial to show you how to use SpatGris on Windows 10 or 11 by using the software Jack. Jack is a software that allows the different programs on your computer to communicate together. For example, you can use it to connect your DAW with SpatGris and the audio interface. Start by downloading Jack from the website's download page. I got the 64-bit installer for Windows 64. To open the program, click on qjackctl.x. It's in the qjackctl folder. I created a shortcut of the qjackctl.x file on my desktop and manually selected the jack.ico to modify the icon. When the program is installed, you'll need to manually modify a notepad file to add input and output channels. Find the folder where Jack is installed on your computer. In my computer, the notepad file is in OS, Program File, Jack 2, Jack Router, Win64, jackrouter.ini. Open jackrouter.ini and insert the number of input and output channels that you need. In SpatGris, the maximum number of output channels you can have is 128, so that's what I wrote there. Save the modified file. If you can't save the file because of security measure, there's something you can do to bypass that. Copy and paste the jackrouter.ini file on your desktop. Open the file on your desktop and modify it there and save it there. When you're done, drag and drop the new jackrouter ini file into the Win64 folder and click Replace the file in the destination. Click Continue. This should allow you to bypass the security and save the changes in the file. Now, Jack will show me up to 128 input and output channels. Next, I will show you which settings to put into Jack. When you're getting ready for a work session, always start by opening Jack before your DAW and before SpatGris. Click on Setup. In the Settings tab, the driver should be at Port Audio and the Real Time should be checked. Select the audio interface that you want to use. I'm on a laptop and I'm using ASIO for All. Select the sample rate and frames that you want to use for your project. The sample rate and frames will automatically apply themselves to the other programs that are connected with Jack. Next, click on the Advanced tab and change the start delay to 20 seconds. This is the number of seconds that it's going to take Jack to load. It might take Jack more or less than 20 seconds to load on your computer, but 20 seconds is a good average. Click Apply to save the changes and click Cancel to close the setup window. Click on Start to start the server. And click on Graph to open the graph window. When Jack is successfully loaded, you'll see the system input and output channels appear. I only have two system outputs because my laptop is in stereo. I could have more outputs depending on the audio interface I was using. Now you can open your DAW and SpatGris. In this example, I'm using Ableton, but you could use any DAW. To connect your programs to jack, you'll have to select jack router as the audio device of your DAW and SpatGris. To do so, go to Options, Preferences, or Control and Comma. In Audio and Audio Device, select Jack Router. Turn on all the inputs and outputs that you want to use. In SpatGris, go to File, Settings. In Audio Input Device, select Jack Router. You can add outputs by clicking the plus and minus sign on the right and adjust the number of sources. Click Apply. Now, your programs should be linked to jack and they should appear in the graph window. Now I can see that all my programs have appeared in the graph window. We are going to delete all these connections and create new ones. To delete all the connections at once, click Ctrl and A to select all and click Delete. If this doesn't work, click Shift and Delete. The outputs of Ableton should go into SpatGris, and the outputs of SpatGris are sent to the audio interface. Create all the connections in the correct order. When you're done creating the connections, you can save the template of the graph you've created to call it back at a later time so that you don't have to manually make the connections every time for the same project. You can exit the graph. To save your graph, click on Session, click Save. Select the folder in which you want to save your graph. Select Folder. Your graph template is now saved in the folder you selected. To call it back, simply click Load. Select the folder, and your graph will be loaded again. Now, if I put the Ctrl Gris plugin in my DAW and insert the correct number for the source and the output, I should be able to receive the signals in the audio interface. I put first source ID 3, two sources, exterior out, 3 and 4. And it works. When you're done, close your programs first and then click Stop to stop the server. And quit. This is what concludes this tutorial. I hope it was helpful and thank you for listening.